Hey folks, Kisaki here with another tutorial. I want to show you another technique of boxing. The uppercut and the hook, or the hook to the head. And yeah, I show it to you with the left and the right hand. Or with my lead and my rear hand, because I like to throw hooks with my leading hand. It's something called unexpected. And yeah, the tutorial builds up on my previous tutorial about boxing, about the check and the punch. And now we will see a little more advanced techniques. I hope you like it. If you are another opinion, if you think other boxing techniques are better or more important, write it in the comments. Perhaps I will make a tutorial on this. Or I say, no, I don't use them because of these and that reasons. So just put it in the comments and we will have a discussion about this. And yeah, as I said, now we're going to talk about the uppercut. Comes like this, and the hook to the head, like this. Probably the uppercut, I cannot show it to you in the spot, because yeah, he's too straight, right? He's not bent over, you know, it's more suitable if somebody is leaning forward and then you can hit him. But it doesn't matter, it's about the technique and you will figure out yeah, where the difficulties are in striking or in refighting purposes, or how you can practice it with the punching bag or whatever. First thing, for boxing, please wear gloves or bandage. It protects your knuckles from getting these cracks and it will increase your training frequency, your safety, and you will come better quicker. And therefore it's more recommended to wear it than anything else. Okay, let's have a look at the technique. First we go to our basic fighting stance, hands up, like in boxing position. And yeah, we'll see. The jab, we had already, jab and the punch. Usually, the hook is thrown as the third strike in a series. So, for example, what I like to do, what one of my favorite combos is jab, punch, hook to the head. Pam, pam. Because the hook, if you're standing like this, the hook will come around the lead hand and hit to the head. And it's, most people don't expect it, you know? I mean, it's a little dangerous because at this moment you have a very open guard. But because of the punch, if you apply it in the right way, your opponent will be distracted or perhaps not in the position to throw something other than a jab, and this will not kill you or probably also not knock you out. But when your hook comes around, he's done, I guess. If you really hit him at the chin or here at the side of the face with full power, it's over. So, how do I throw a hook? What I think is very important is to have a rectangular shape of your arm and to keep it stiff. Some people like to throw it like a swinging motion or whatever. It's not a cross, it's not a swing, it's a hook. And a hook has a hook shape, I say. And what I do, jab, punch, and then I come out. Here I build the rectangular shape here, and then I pivot with my whole body. And this gives this punch a tremendous amount of power. And so the other side, pam, pam, pam. You see, I go a little lower, and with both feet, I turn nearly sideways. That's the hook to the head. You can also throw it in a four series, left, right, left, and then pump. That's what you see more often in boxing, and this is also a very good combination. As always, I recommend a lot to practice it in shadow boxing, so without hitting anything, focusing on the technique, and really get the technique down so that if you take yourself on video and you do it 20 times, it should look like you put just a repeat button and it looks always the same. And there should be no issues. And then you have the technique done. And then you can go unboxing and try to get it harder and faster. And yeah, then you have good technique. Also, you can practice it with some light weights, like about 1 pound of weight or something. It will increase your striking power. You see, I already opened my knuckles here. Oh my. That's a sign of bad technique actually, but it's also a little bit due to the bandage. It puts my finger in a strange way, so I did not always hit full with the knuckle. Sometimes I hit first with the tips of the fingers, so, but it's not a serious issue. The second technique I want to recommend you, or I want to show you, is the uppercut. Also a 4-strike and a 4 combination. Also, we have the rectangular shape of the arm. Left, right, left, and then uppercut, bam. Probably somebody advances at you, and he's like this. And you see it very often, they come at you and throw their strikes like crazy. And then you wait until he sees in range, and you come and use the uppercut, and you hit him right into the face. Also, the uppercut actually aims for the solar plexus. If you hit here for the solar plexus, so really, you go here for the solar plexus, and the fist comes up and hits right under the chin. And this is a KO. So I recommend this also. What else is to say? Not really much. You can also do it with the front hand. Not that powerful, but you see I have more range. And if I see, oh, he's putting head down, arms like this, here is open, I can come to bam, and you have it directly into the face. Bam. Not that bad, often a hit, often some points. You must see if it is allowed to throw hooks with your leading hand. That's not allowed in all martial arts. But we're talking about street fighting, we're talking about some serious stuff. And there it is allowed, of course. What I also want to show you is what I call rolling or diving, and it's a kind of this motion in your upper body. Left, right, dive, cha cha, cha cha. Here you stay a little bit more squared than in our basic fighting sense. It's a bit like in Mabu, like Kung Fu. So both feet are at the same line, so to say. And you're a little lower because you will need to lower your body, so it's not a movement like this with your whole back. It comes from the legs. It's like a squatting position, you know? And then you throw left, right, left, right, left. Or it's actually a little bit of a combination of both. So you can use a little bit your back, but don't do it too much. If you bend over and he gets your neck, and then he can push you easily down. But if you're just squatting down, he cannot push you down, you can easily stand up. You have a lot more power in your upper legs than he can put weight on you. I mean, I don't know, probably can squat with about, I don't know, 200 pounds or something like this. So this would be no problem when you're just going down with your legs, you know. Your head should form more a circular motion, like an O, than a U. So it's not downside up, so it's more like circling, you can see. And really, if you believe it or not, do it in fights sometimes. Not often, because it's predictable and you're not too fast, but sometimes it helps. You strike here, and you dive, and you come around, and really, your opponent does not know where you are. Because at some point, you just move out of his sight, and that's the best opportunity to hit him hard. He really needs 1 or 2 seconds to realize, oh, he's to the left, not to the right, or he's not falling to the ground, he's just beside me. You know? Why am I showing you this technique in a tutorial about the hook? Simply for that, I can throw left, right, dive, and then I come out here with the hook. And that's really good. So this hook is more like sideways. It's not just up or just like to the head. It also goes like to the head. You know? stripe is more on the diagonal. I do it like this, because this is a liver shot. Here's the liver, and it's on the, here on the right arm. So if I throw left, right, diving, hook, you hit them directly in the liver. And this side also has also KO potential. So I think that's it. I have not much more to say to these things. I hope you liked the tutorial. I hope you subscribe and you enjoyed the video. See you next time. Always stay awake and one step ahead. Thanks for watching.